Pittman 2010 political coverage now. Recent polls show Republican Pat Toomey and Democrat Joe Sestak in a tight, tight race for U.S. Senate. And one of the most controversial ads in this campaign was not put on the air by either one of them.
The U.S. Chamber of Commerce is behind an ad criticizing Sestak's voting record in Congress. 8 on Your Side government reporter Matt Belanger is here with another Ad Watch report.
Yeah, and this ad has really also become one of the most talked about out there because two Western Pennsylvania television stations actually pulled it off the air for a short time because Sestak's campaign complained it was inaccurate. Both of those TV stations later reversed those decisions. Here's what we found when we checked the facts.
Joe Sestak gives it 100% to Nancy Pelosi.
In this political ad, the U.S. Chamber of Commerce attacks Democratic Senate candidate Joe Sestak by linking him to Speaker of the House Nancy Pelosi. The ad is centered around this main claim.
Sestak voted with Pelosi 100% of the time.
On the News 8 AdWatch Truth Meter, this one registers as false. We compared Sestak's votes to Pelosi's votes and found when both of them were present and voting, you actually come up with Sestak agreeing with Pelosi 97.8% of the time. That's not 100%, but even if you think we're being too picky by pointing that out, there's another problem.
On this vote, the yeas are...
What you may not realize, and the ad does not mention, is while the Speaker of the House has the right to vote, historically, he or she rarely exercises that right. In fact, of the 447 roll call votes cast in the House so far this year, Speaker Pelosi has only selected to vote 34 times. So to compare Sestak's voting record to Pelosi's is a bit misleading, considering Sestak cast hundreds more votes than Pelosi. In fact, if what you really want to know is how often Sestak votes against his fellow Democrats, we found that has happened 27 times during the current session of Congress. And not just on procedural votes like motions to adjourn, but on issues like against a move to exempt some large advocacy groups like the NRA from having to disclose their campaign spending, which Pelosi supported. And even though the ad was not put on the air by Sestak's Republican opponent in the Senate race, Pat Toomey, he says he agrees with its message.
Do you support the claims made in that chamber advertisement?
Well, listen, it's not my job to defend somebody else's ad. But the point that I made yesterday and I would reiterate today is that Joe Sestak has, in fact, been in lockstep with Nancy Pelosi. I think it's very clear that he has been one of her great lieutenants and a great supporter of her agenda.
The Sestak campaign also takes issue with the ad's description of the health care reform bill as a, quote, government takeover. Remember, the public option never made it into the law. And we've pointed out before how opponents and supporters are still debating whether that new law constitutes a government takeover.